Boxes!
Actually, I don't know if there's any other characters. And then we got Titus, but for some reason Titus is a kid, so this would have to be when Titus is a little kid. So this would have to go way before Sin attacked Zanarkin. So, you know, they'd have to go back for that for Walken and Titus to be kids. Never mind these three, because these are Kingdom Hearts 2 exclusives. And, okay, now let's go back. Let's go turn back the time. Kingdom Hearts 1 did not happen. Well, actually, even go forward. Kingdom Hearts 2, you have to go back and play memories. This is where you'll see Cloud, if I can find a picture of Cloud on here. But this is where this is the game that Cloud's in, too. But that's because you're fixing the memories of this with Organization 13 attacking you. Okay, now let's go back in time. And I'm going to go back in time and explain. Okay, Cloud won the battle against Sephiroth. Cloud defeated Sephiroth successfully. Sephiroth didn't destroy any Final Fantasy world. He was never a Heartless. Sephiroth is done. It's over. The Remnants come. Avid Children comes ever. 3 years after Final Fantasy VII, boom. Final Fantasy Avid Children. You got yourself the Remnants. One of the Remnants take the Genova cells and puts in his body, turns himself into Sephiroth. And if anyone knows, you can't go to Kingdom Hearts 2 yet because 3 years, Vincent actually finishes off the storyline of Final Fantasy VII. If anyone knows Final Fantasy VII like I do, Vincent actually finishes off the story. He defeats the rest of Shinra's elite group called Deep Ground, which that's for another time, another day. And I'll talk about who Deep Ground is at a later time, later day. Right now, I'm not interested. I'm interested in the Kingdom Hearts. Yes, Vincent Valtop's not in the Kingdom Hearts series, but the reason why this is important is because he's the one who finishes out Final Fantasy VII's story, which if Final Fantasy VII's world's done, really begins 8th story. And this one's time-based right here because the sorcerers could use the power of time for stuff. What if Ultimecia, through Adele, or... And this goes back to the whole Squall's dead theory. What if he didn't die? What if he got attacked by a powerful tech, got sent to Kingdom Hearts 1? And how come he lost his memory? That's another theory, another time. I'm not going to get into it. We just know after Final Fantasy VII, this happens. Final Fantasy IX happens after 8 finishes Squall Saves the World. Kuja and, Necron gets defeated. That world's saved. Then we get into this, which, in this one, Auron comes into the Kingdom Hearts world. Titus is a grown man, and he saves Zanarkin. You know the Final Fantasy X story. Now, this is the Kingdom Hearts 2, but I believe Kingdom Hearts 2 is after this game, because somehow they get turned to pixies, which, that's another thing. Another time, another day. Probably for Disney effect, because they wanted to have more pixies, because Disney effect. So these three girls. So these two are done. So you remember, Cloud defeats Sephiroth. Sephiroth comes back, and you have to fight Sephiroth again as a fake Sephiroth. Vincent finishes the story. 8-9 happens. 10 and 10-2 happens. And then what happens after all of this? What happens? Bang! Kingdom Hearts 2. You know why this is very important? I'm going to explain right now. Take out the rest of the game. Take out all the stuff. Oh, shit. Sorry. I got this at Vintage Stock Wii U, so forgive me if the disc comes flying out, but take everything out. Take all this out. The reason why these two are important is this right here would be the storyline if Cloud would have defeated Sephiroth. You would have your normal Avid Children, Dirge of Cerberus. And the reason why this is important, Cloud takes on, in this game, Kingdom Hearts 2, takes on the appearance of this Cloud. And in this version of Cloud, he's a good guy. He's not bad. He was never a bad or evil character to begin with in Kingdom Hearts 1, but he doesn't do anything bad. This time, he's one of the heroes. He's one of the good guys. And because Sephiroth didn't destroy his world, so But he knows Sephiroth comes back because Remnant Sephiroth is still strong enough. He can even exist in this Kingdom Hearts. But in this Kingdom Hearts, just like the other Kingdom Hearts, Sephiroth is a Heartless, made out of Cloud's darkness. Every time Cloud thinks of evil shit, Sephiroth comes back, so... But instead of original Sephiroth, this Sephiroth right here, which is why he's easier, comes back in this world, but he's still hard and challenging as fuck. But, you know, nonetheless, the reason why these two games are important, this is the timeline where Cloud defeats Sephiroth. And the reason why that's important, not only put the games in perspective, and in order, too. Here's your first two games. That happens because that's the first Final Fantasy character to actually come into the world of Kingdom Hearts. Let's see, character-wise, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, take these out, 10, 10, 2, there was never 11 or 12, which you should already know if you're a Kingdom Hearts fan. There were never any characters from 10 or 11, so we're not going to count those universes. And, you know, and then, you know, really, this, depending on the timeline, things could change. So, if those two didn't happen, boom, these would have happened. And then Kingdom Hearts 2, and if you want to elaborate even more further, there's even more. Now, if you want to go even extend the universes a little bit more, all the characters from the Final Fantasy games that go in the Kingdom Hearts world and goes back to the original world, gets attacks and power-ups from both worlds. And you know why this is important? Dissidia, Dual Deathdom. That's why there's a DLC of Cloud, Squall, and Sephiroth as Kingdom Hearts characters. And this is just the first Dissidia. Second Dissidia, these are the last of the universes. After the world saving Dissidia, and I'm going to talk about Dissidia timeline once I collect all the Final Fantasies. Possible. That's for another day, another time. Dissidia happens, both Dissidia and Duodestum. Dissidia is the first one, you know, Duodestum is the second. That's the final of the universes. That's why there's Kingdom Hearts, Cloud, Squall, and Sephiroth, because, well, this whole entire timeline right here I'm showing you has to happen. Has to happen for this to happen. But you don't necessarily have to have Kingdom Hearts for the city to happen. The city would happen anyway. I mean, anyways. But, you know. But this is my whole thing. My whole chronologically theory of the Final Fantasy Kingdom Hearts crossover timeline. And please leave a comment if you know, have any more ideas of how the timeline is. My theory is Yensid went to all these worlds and saved all these people before the Heartless Sephiroth got a hold of somebody, you know? And then Cloud gets revenge on Sephiroth. But nonetheless, this is my whole timeline theory of Final Fantasy characters, Kingdom Hearts crossover. Please leave a comment. I'll leave the comments open for this video only and this video only. This is what I'm going to be working on, so this might take hours and hours to work on, and this might have two parts like I feared, so, yeah.